Good morning. I'm Jessica. I'm 37 and I have cystic fibrosis. This is a genetic condition affecting mostly lungs and the digestive tract. As CF is an evolving disease, you need to get monitored quite regularly. So for instance, in my case, I go to CF clinic every 3 months and I see an pneumologist. I do breathing exercise to check my lung capacity. I got the sputum tested of what is going up from the lungs. Every 6 months I need to go to diabetologist. Every 6 months also I need to see the ENT, and once a year I do a complete checkup of 1 day in hospital with IRM, blood test, and some other exams. Every month I need to go to pharmacy to get the refill of my daily medication, and when needed I also call them if I need some extra antibiotics. Usually when I have IV, that's because I'm weaker, and so they tend to bring me directly all the drugs at home, so I don't have to get out and to carry this these quite heavy boxes of medicine. Also, what is part of my daily treatment is to have at least 1 hour of daily activity. And usually I walk, and that's fine, but I need to make sure that I do physical activity. When I was younger, I was told that because of CF, it was not recommended to do some sport, but nowadays it has changed. And we see that all CF patients that have daily or at least frequent physical activity are coping better. Living with cystic fibrosis can be quite challenging because the daily treatments are for every day. So you don't have any break, you don't have any weekend or holiday. Because you live with a genetic condition that is evolving constantly, and so by aging the disease will become more and more difficult to cope with, so you need to comply with a strict policy of doing your treatment every day. CF patients usually have breathing difficulty because of the CFTR protein that is not functioning correctly, and that is creating very thick mucus in the whole body. Every day I have to do some breathing exercise, that is airway clearance. And I go to a physiotherapist to be helped with that. What has helped me a lot is to share my experience with other CF patients through CF community and the CF Foundation. So it's true that it's not recommended that we speak to each other and that we meet in real life, but as nowadays everybody is locked down in their house, we see that we can chat via message, via telephone, and there is no danger of cross-contamination if you are not in the same room as another CF patient. So I think this is really encouraging that we can express our issues and see that other people have already come through this type of issue. That is quite motivating for the future.